to After Total Divas. Me and Ms. Fox here.
Hey, babe.
We are going to be recapping everything that happens on Total Divas, which of course airs on the E! Network. So, this season, there is so much drama going on already. I mean, we saw episode one, the way it all played out in episode two. We're going to get into our weekly Diva Dish. We're going to recap the three main subjects that happened on this week's show. So, very first one, Battle of the Blondes.
Summer, I have a question for you. Have you ever slept with anybody at work?
Whoa.
I honestly can't put my finger on what it is about Summer that really doesn't gel with me. Sometimes we'll have to work together in the ring, and she honestly impresses me. But the little act that she's an innocent lamb is something I'm not personally buying anymore.
It's always hot when Summer's around, so it's your turn.
Whoa.
You know, you got the newbies coming in. How do you treat them?
You treat them like rookies, but I can understand the divas have a lot of tension because we all have egos.
Yes.
But Summer has a slick tongue, girl.
It
is
she does.
So quick. I'm like, she said that insult before, but that's just my opinion. I don't know. I'm just saying.
In the face.
As I turn around to put AJ up in my finisher, I get a super kick straight to my face and literally knocks my tooth out.
Unfortunately, in the ring, pretty much anything can happen, from bumps and bruises and blood, and heaven forbid you get a tooth knocked out. And it's just one of those things that we hope doesn't happen in our careers, but probably will happen.
I can't go make out with my boyfriend. He'll think I'm ugly.
You know, you're sounding like a little prissy, vain girl to me. The fact that you don't want to see him because of your look. Who cares?
That happens.
All the
time.
You
guys get bruised, scratched, hurt, hair pulled, all sorts of things. You expect some of this stuff to happen. So for her to be freaked out about how John's going to feel about her tooth situation, weird, right?
As a female, I think I'd be in the same boat.
It's badass. I would embrace it. All right, and our last topic, photo finish.
Like with Eva, I feel like she makes herself seem like she's just like better than everyone. Everyone has like skeletons in their closet. She has like some scandalous pictures. Here's one.
I'm completely shocked and so caught off guard because I don't really know how many people she showed, but she definitely has no idea by just bringing them up and showing these photos that I did when I was like 20, how hurtful it is to me.
Not only is it childish, but it's extremely unprofessional. I just think she's full of
that
well done,
my
good job.
That wasn't
but
my intention.
But I'm definitely not accepting your apology.
Okay, so Eva Marie, we find these photos of her online. I'm not saying I had nothing to do with it. Neither did you.
No.
But the way that it was brought up and just the one-upmanship between Eva Marie and Cameron, how do you think of the way that was handled?
I think it was handled just like little girls.
Yeah.
I think Cameron could have pulled Eva aside, like Summer pulled her aside and say, hey, listen, you're a girl. This is what's been going on. And
sort it out a little bit.
Yeah, just
have each other's backs.
Exactly.
Have each other's backs. Well, with a little bit more insight on that, let's bring on our guest. We've got Naomi.
Yay.
Hey,
ladies.
Hi, babe.
How are you?
Mom. I'm good.
Good to see you out here.
Thank you.
Okay, so you dealt with this whole situation like an absolute professional.
Well, I did that because I know Cameron, and Cameron is so sweet. She's so funny, and that was totally out of her character. And I spoke with Eva, and I realized that Cameron didn't know what those pictures represented or meant to Eva. Had she known, she would have never done anything like that.
Yeah.
But I think they were both just being catty with each other, and Cameron was just trying to get one up on her.
Like, do you know about, like, her past and, like, what those pictures symbolize? Because
like, it's way deeper than it just being a picture.
Well, it wasn't like I was maliciously trying to do it.
Yeah, you were.
It's in her past. It's done. It's over with. And I think they both learned a lot from the situation.
Don't try to keep that ammo in your back pocket. It's not cool.
No.
Okay, now that you are here as our honorary guest, you get to announce who our winner for the soundbite of last week
yes,
was.
I love doing this. And the soundbite winner for last week is...
So good to see you.
That's the fakest press on nails voice.
Okay, so now we're moving on to this week's soundbites from episode number 2.
Maybe if it gets a little cold, I can borrow one of Natty's double-breasted blazers.
Ew.
Never ever make fun of Natalia because she is from the Heart Dungeon. She will mess you up.
Eva is still considered a newbie.
It's like all red, everything.
It's like, it's all red, everything. My name is Eva.
And the third soundbite comes from John Cena.
As long as you promise no tooth jokes.
No jokes. That's the tooth.
It's the tooth. It was a good line.
Good line. Great line. I'm
so
sorry, Nikki.
We want you guys to log on to WWEdivas.com to get your votes in, and we'll find out who the winner is for the soundbite king or queen at the very end of the show. All right, now it's time for you to do your love it or lose it. What you liked, what you didn't like.
All right, love it. I mean, didn't you guys see that tour bus? I mean, wine cellar, California King, washer and dryer? I'm sorry, but my rental car is almost not cutting it. Nikki, you are riding in style. And hey, I need a ride to the next town. All right, lose it. These girls can't even get along in the locker room. What makes you think that they'll get along in a tight, squeeze tour bus without any drama? I say lose the idea.
Well, that about nicely wraps up this edition of After Total Divas, looking at everything that happens on Total Divas. This season is off to the races. I love it.
Next week on Total Divas.
No erections on the bus?
Weird. Summer actually came up to me. She was like, I care what you think about people thinking I've slept with somebody.
I'm gonna find her. Summer, when it comes to my man, no.
That is a slutty, rude, classless thing to do. You come out there and you shake your ass. You practically wear nothing.
Natty.
Divas are role
Natty,
models.
Please.
You're on the verge of being a stripper.
So make sure to come back here immediately after Total Divas airs on the E! Network, 9 p.m. Eastern Time. Then we will be right back here stirring the pot, seeing what's going on. See you guys later.